This video goes with section 22 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course and covers the future indicative active of thematic verbs that end in omega. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn page 48 for their coverage of the material in this video, and the appendix has it on page 655. The future indicative active is future time and simple or continuous aspect, and to form it, we need principal part 2 and endings. So let's start with luo's principal parts, luo, luso, elusa, leluca, lelumai, eluthane, and go to the second one. Get the stem by taking off the omega. Now we need the endings and a chart to put them in. Singular and plural, first, second, and third person. And here are the endings. O, ace, a, omen, ete, usi, or usen, with that new movable. Now look at those endings. You already know them. O, ace, a, omen, ete, usi. They are the same as the present indicative active endings. That's the good news. So the difference between past and present will only be the principal part, and you'll need to see that sigma in the middle of the word to know whether you're looking at a present or future verb, which I suppose you could take as bad news. The accent on the future indicative active is recessive. The default translation for the future indicative active is she will verb for future time and simple aspect, or she will be verbing if you want to stress the continuous aspect. So let's put it together. Principal part 2, endings, recessive accent, and a chart to put them in. Let's start with principal part 2. So here we have the persons and numbers filled in with the second principal part stem of luo. Now we need endings. And here they are. O, ace, a, omen, ete, usi. And there's the new movable if you want it. Now we need recessive accent. So we have to follow the rules for accent in the recessive pattern, where we look at the last syllable and see how far back in the word an acute accent can go. So if we look at the first person singular, luso, we can see that we have a long last syllable, and we can count 1, 2, and go back to the second to last syllable to put on the acute. Next, in the second person singular, luses, we have a long last syllable. We count 1, 2, and put in the acute. Third person singular, long last syllable, 1, 2, acute. First person plural has a short last syllable. So we go 1, 2, 3, and the acute goes on the third to last. The same happens in the second person plural. Epsilon is short, so that's a short last syllable, and we count 1, 2, 3 back to the acute on the third to last syllable. And finally, third person plural, that's a short iota, so short 1, 2, 3 and the acute. That's the whole conjugation of the future indicative active of luo. So it's luso, I will free, luses, you will free, luse, she will free, lusomen, we will free, lusata, y'all will free, and lususi, they will free. Let's try it with another verb. Here's paideuo and its six principal parts. Paideuo, paideuso, epaideusa, pepaideuka, pepaideumai, epaideuthane. We go to the second principal part, and take off the omega to get our stem, paideos. Then we add the ending, o, and the recessive accent. O is long, so it can only go back to the second to last, paideoso. I will educate. Second person singular. Stem, ending, accent, paideoses. You will educate. Third person singular. Paideose. Stem, ending, acute, on the second to last because the last is long. And this means she will educate, or he will educate, or it will educate. And all of those could be she will be educating if we want to stress the continuous aspect of the future. First person plural is paideosomen, stem from the second principal part, ending and acute. Second person plural, paideoseta, y'all will educate. And finally, third person plural, paideosusi, or with the new movable, paideosusen, and the accent, they will educate. And there you have the future indicative active. You should be able to apply this to other verbs now and be ready for drills, classwork, and translations.